Two South Georgians will compete in the Boston Marathon tomorrow, but this year marks the somber moment in the race's history, 10 years since the deadly bombing. He told WALB News 10's Anthony Bardonero why he's going back.
April 15, 2013 is a day that Mike Beeman will never forget. He tells me what he saw as he was about to finish the race.
After the initial, I guess you call it horror, I walked up where the finish line actually was. I saw all the devastation. There was just blood everywhere, broken glass. The sidewalk was uprooted. There was one young man who was deceased. He was laying there on the sidewalk. It was awful. It's certainly a memory that I don't cherish.
Beeman still runs the race every single year. He will run, get ready for it, his 46th Boston Marathon on Monday. He's raced through the rain and the cold at the same time, and the pandemic. He tells me what makes the race so special.
Fans, the people that are on the course, are so knowledgeable, so supportive. If you have a bib number in Boston, you are a rock star.
Beeman says that he also loves the tradition and qualifying aspect of the race. Another South Georgian is participating in the race, but he has less experience. Jim O'Connor is from Cook County. He is running his first Boston Marathon on
52, rain, maybe a little headwind, 10, 15 miles an hour. I think it's going to actually be a good day. I'm going to enjoy it a little bit. I take everything in that I can, so probably spend a few miles with Mike out there on the road, too.
Okay, so maybe I'm not racing the Boston Marathon this year, but if you are or know somebody who is in the Southwest Georgia area, be sure to shout them out on Facebook and tag me, and I'll share it and give them a shout out as well. I'm Anthony Bordenaro, reporting for WALB, your hometown news source.